Presentation nerves are completely natural. 9 out of 10 people suffer from them. If you're the 1 in 10 that doesn't, lucky you. However, if you do suffer from nerves, best thing you can do is breathe. You breathe in to a slow count of 5, and then out to the same slow count of 6. And you will feel your pulse gentling, you'll feel yourself feeling calmer. Everything kind of just seems a better place. The world seems a better place. The other thing that you need to do is pay attention to your audience. Don't worry about yourself. If things go wrong, which they will, just make it okay for the audience. As long as they're sitting there thinking, oh, that happened to me last Thursday, you haven't got a problem. If they're sitting there worrying about you, then you have a problem. At the beginning of a presentation, what you don't want is to give them a boring and predictable introduction. If, for example, you get a set of results and you just try and hit me with a whole bunch of data, I'm not going to remember it. If you tell me about the moment that you got those results and they thrilled you or they frustrated you, let me share your excitement, let me share your frustration, then I'll remember. Audiences are like magpies. I don't know if you know about the behavioural habits of magpies, but they like shiny things. Any kind of bling is good. And those are the bits that get taken back to their nest. Now, it doesn't matter how good you are, if you throw a whole bunch of data at your audience like that and expect them to remember it, they won't. If you give them little shiny polished messages, stories, analogies, anecdotes, all those sort of things, case histories, specific examples, those are the shiny bits. They're the bits that go back to the nest. I can't tell you how many presentations I see where all I see is the back of someone's head or possibly their right ear because they're pointing at the screen behind them or they're talking to the screen behind them. Big mistake. You want to be talking to your audience. Look forward. If you smile, I can hear a smile. If you are surprised, your eyebrows go up and your voice goes up with it. If you're in despair, everything sort of sags and your voice goes down with it. So facial expressions and voice work as one. One of the biggest mistakes is over-practicing. If you're writing a script and trying to stick to it slavishly, you put yourself in kind of a straitjacket. If you do use notes, be obvious about it. Don't pretend you're not using notes. I've seen people using PresenterView on PowerPoint that look as if they're about to go and rob a bank because they're just sort of doing that. With an academic paper, I can read it as many times as I like over as many cups of coffee as I need. And over time I'll get it. With a presentation, you have to get me on the first pass. I have to understand it straight away. So keep it really, really simple, even to the point it might offend you. If you're doing bullet points, if you must, 3 is the magic number. Never more than 3 per slide. We're pre-programmed to remember things in threes. And if you are doing bullet points, keep them tight, really short. If you need to use a pointer, there's something wrong with the slide, it's too busy. You can pre-select what you want us to see. You can circle things, you can draw boxes around them, you can highlight them. If you're waving a pointer around manically, which happens a lot of the time, we may or may not bother to look at where you're pointing. If you tell us where to look, we'll look there. And finally, finishing off your talk. If you can leave us with a big idea, something to take home, that's a good thing. But one thing you must not do is tell us this is your take-home message. It makes your audience very grumpy and makes them think they'll take any message home except the one you've told them to. But above all, enjoy yourself. If you enjoy yourself, the audience will have enjoyed your talk.